Alright, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to MYM Nations Cup, 3rd edition. WAG TV is working, says Angie, so that's a brilliant treat for you guys who want to watch it through WAG TV. Yes, welcome to MYM Nations Cup, 3rd edition. Winner's bracket, we've got Serbia playing against Lebanon in today's game. We've had it a little bit delayed, but the teams have finally arrived. Lebanon seemed to have some issues, but they have been resolved. The full team is in the game, and we're jumping straight into the picking phase. Serbia sitting on the first pick, so we're going to play their national anthem first. I hope I've got the right one. This one is pretty short, but it's going to do. So we're going to have the Serbian national anthem. I hope it's not too loud, actually. Is it even going to play? There we go. We're going to have the Serbian national anthem running in the background, of course. As you might have noticed, the Sentinel nicks, the Serbian nicks seem a little bit weird. But the actual way the Serbia is spelt in the Cyrillic language is something along these lines. The 6 is supposed to be some sort of a B, and then you can imagine how this would be pronounced, Serbia. Close. Yes, I will be saving. Lebanon, much more easy to understand. Actually have their country name written in English, so that shouldn't be too hard to figure out. Anyway, we're jumping into the banning phase. We've got Visage and Ancient Apparition removed from Serbia. Nothing new or spectacular here. And the Scourge, Lebanon, have got rid of Invoker as well as Nerubian Weaver. So no surprises here. What could be surprising, though, is of course that this tournament is playing with CMUB. I believe it has been typed in, so it's not just CM. Meaning that both of the teams are allowed to use new heroes that are usually banned in Captain's Mode. Of course, the UB tag means unban, and that means that the usually banned heroes are unbanned, and we can see that they are. We've got Shadow Demon in the pool, for instance. I believe we've got Treant Protector. Yes, we do. We've got Wisp. Phoenix, Tuskar. A lot of good stuff is available, so we'll see if any of the teams decide to pick that one up. But so far, so good. No new heroes have been banned from either team of the unbanned heroes. So either they've agreed on auto-banning all of them, or they're just not considering them worthy. And we'll see which turns out to actually be true. Batrider taken out by Serbia. And it's now all in Lebanon's court. Yes, this was indeed a short national anthem version. I am sorry about that. Lebanon will get about twice as much time, but that's how it goes. This might actually be a little bit loud. Oops, wrong button. So there we go. And Lebanon are choosing to use extra time. Serbia has used some extra time as well, so definitely putting some effort into these bans, but not getting rid of the new heroes, as I've mentioned, and neither did Lebanon on their third ban. They got rid of the Earthshaker, and didn't take Serbia too long to figure out that they wanted the Clockwork Goblin, a very powerful early mid-game hero with his powerful rockets, the ability to catch heroes, and very, very nice setup for both gangs as well as teamfights. By being a perfect engage with that long-range hookshot of his. Lebanon's quick response, Morphling. Shouldn't need too much explanation. Very powerful laning hero, very powerful carry hero. Hard to kill. The morph skill is makes him very, very hard to bring down if he gets that pup, so he keeps changing agility to strength, or the other way around. And Crystal Maiden. So, very classic setup for a top-tier game, this. A Clockwork is a very, very high pick, and Maiden Morphling is a very classic setup, so nothing spectacular so far. And it seems like Lebanon just really wanted to get their hands on that carry as early as possible. Believe they used it. They used this Maiden Morphling first pick. They had that against Germany as well, and it really paid out for them in that game. The Morphling became ridiculously powerful and in the end carried it through. So might be settling to try and do that again. Vengeful Spirit coming up for Serbia. So far very aggressive roaming heroes here. We'll probably settle for some carry as well. We know Gordon, the captain for the Serbian team, is a very, very big fan of farming. So we'll probably see a hard carry coming out on him. One of his favorite heroes is a farm conker. Might see Serbians using that one. Could also be something along the lines of perhaps a Potom, Draw Ranger, Shadow Fiend. We'll see what he chooses to go for. So far, the Vengeful Spirit, of course, is set up for the Nether Swap. Has got very nice synergy with the Clockwork Cog. You can play nicely around with that, swapping people into cogs, out of cogs. The Stunned Terror just a very brilliant roaming laning hero as well, and now Windrunner coming up too. No surprise there either. Yes, very, very trendy picks, you have to say right here, so shouldn't be too surprising and unusual to for you as viewers to see these picks coming up. We'll see if they go for something more more controversial in the second picking phase, but so far I believe Lebanon will settle for something pretty standard as well. Earthshaker would have been perfect for the picks they've got right now, but they banned that one themselves, so might be looking to pick up something along the lines of perhaps the Shadow Fiend for middle. Could get the Sven. Witch Doctor is an option as well if they like playing with that one for the trial lane. Yeah, a lot of options are available, of course, especially if the new heroes are also up for picking. Pugna, also available. I think Lebanon likes to play with that Pugna. They had it against the Germans as well in one of the games, at least. Invoker was banned. Never mind. That one is out of the pool. Well, there you fucking go. And it's going to be a Tidehunter coming out for them right now, so that's a little bit special, but not too surprising seeing that it's Lebanon that picks it. Of course, Lebanon primarily consisting, if not completely consisting, of the team Unique Dota. And they like playing around with Tide, so why not use it in the official Prime Nations matches as well. So it's going to be a Tidehunter. The Pugna's been banned from by Serbia here. So they did hear my call about the Pugna. Don't want to play against it. Powerful pushing hero. Very nice control hero, as we will put on some music again as the national anthems have run out. Hopefully the sound levels are all good. Yeah, and the bans are now on Lebanon's side. It's going to be a Razor thrown out. Razor, not sure how well it's synergized with the picks Serbia has so far. But might just not want to play against it at all. Of course, a nice counter pick to Morphling as well. Razor. Morphling, being the short-range hero who he has to waveform in to get the fight going, and then Razor can put that static link on him, stealing his damage and making Morphling virtually worthless in the fights themselves. So could have been a nice counterpick for the Serbians, and that might be the reasoning behind the ban. Puck being thrown away by Serbia as well, as the Pugna, so getting rid of those two powerful int nuking heroes that work brilliantly for team fights as well. And that could show us an idea for Serbia to either try to dodge teamfights by getting rid of these two, or settling for the better teamfight themselves. But of course, they've seen that Lebanon have already picked up Tidehunter, and that really illustrates that these guys want to take teamfights, and that might be the reasoning behind Serbia's banning these two key teamfight heroes, trying to evade the teamfights and settling for more of a gang-pushing-based strategy. Clockwork Rockets, great for pushing. Windrunner Power Shot can keep a lot of pressure on the lanes while the fighting is going on other lanes. Alchemist being thrown out by Lebanon. Nice Miner's Armor synergy with a Vengeful Spirit, so might be one part of the reasoning behind it. And yeah, Serbia's going to pick up that Shadow Fiend as called, so we're probably going to see that in the hands of Gordon. Could also be playing Windrunner, we'll see how that one turns out. And yeah, now the Scourge needs to find some response to this Lebanon. They're playing a Morphling right now in the late game or in the teamfight setup. They're playing a Morphling against a Shadow Fiend as well as a Windrunner, if you want to look in terms of full carry and semi-carry heroes. And Morphling can definitely handle that with a good teamfight setup. If the team can play around him, he can pick them off one by one in that fight, especially once he gets the Ethereal Blade for bursting out one target immediately when the fight starts. If not, this Sentinel hero lineup is very, very powerful against him. They've got Shackle Shot. It's going to lock him in place, giving Shadow Fiend time to get off those razors. Vengeful Spirit Swap can also be very, very useful against the Morphling. Once he's waveformed in, he's sort of stuck in that place because he can't even run out again. The swap is going to bring him back in and eventually take him down. So it looks like Lebanon will have to settle for a nice lane for that Morphling and then try to put their eyes on some team fighting in the mid-game on the back of this Tidehunter, who definitely needs to get that level 6 in not too long, or the Sentinel heroes will just be too powerful in the early mid-game. As said, Clockwork, Vengeful Spirit, Shadow Fiend, and Windrunner all powerful in the early mid-game, and Serbia might actually try to rush for this, really put some powerful pressure on in the early game and try to win it in not too long, because Morphling is a ticking bomb. Later on, he's going to be a threat, and they might want to try to avoid that. Lebanon seem to be using a lot of time for thinking about what to pick up here, while Serbia are just instant on the button, getting their hands on that lich. Definitely knew they wanted that from the start off. Lion was the pick from Lebanon here. Very powerful utility hero, of course, has the Hex, the Impale, and the Finger of Death to get rid of any hero, disabling him for a long time and eventually letting his team finish him off if the Finger isn't enough. Could have been a counterpick to this Shadow Fiend. We know Shadow Fiends like to go for BKBs, and if there's something that's good against a BKB, it's a Hex. As strange as that might sound, the whole idea is to get the Hex off before the actual BKB, as raw damage itself is not going to be enough here when you've already seen the other Scourge heroes, Morphling, Maiden, and Tide. Once that BKB is popped, the only guy dealing damage is the Morphling. However, if they can get the Hex off from the Lion, they can definitely burst him down with Waveform, Gush, as well as a Finger. And Tinker is going to follow up on that idea. Lots of burst damage. Suddenly, Lebanon seems to change their plans, or maybe this was the plan all along. Some sort of a teamfight set up with that Tidehunter, but apart from that, some very powerful bursting damage. Tinker, Lion, as well as Morphling can deal about 1,200 damage by just using a couple of spells each on the engage, if not even more, 1,500. Some of it even being pure with the laser. So, we might really see the Lebanese boys try to take this fight to the Serbians. So, mark my words when I say, ladies and gentlemen, that this is going to be an action-packed game. I hope the teams don't prove me wrong now, but if you look at the heroes, this will be a kill party. Didn't introduce Lich too much, but of course is going to be important as well. Chain Frost as well as Frost Nova, and especially the armor here. If it goes late, the Frost armor is going to be a powerful tool against that Morphling's right clicks, while the Tinker can pretty much ignore it, and that might have been another part of the reasoning behind Lebanon's Tinker pick. He goes through armor. The rocket, the laser, it just doesn't care. His Ginzu, his Shivers, whatever he chooses to pick up. He couldn't care less about armor. Anyway, we've got a short pause. I'm not sure what we're waiting for. We're waiting for the Serbians for a moment, I think. Actually, both Serbia as well as Lebanon have a player out. But luckily, they've picked their hero, so we can introduce who's playing what for what team. We've got Gordon playing the Windrunner, so no big surprise there. He was Windrunner or Shadow Fiend, I would have expected. We've got Victor playing the Vengeful Spirit, roaming support. Grisine playing the Clockwork. Baya playing the secondary. Not sure how much it will be support and how much it will be. They're probably going to trial line it. We'll see how they figure that one out. Playing the Lich. Baya used to play support as well when he was active in the scene. We've got Cat playing the Shadow Fiend. Not surprising either. Semi-carry player is this Cat, so no big surprise coming out here. On the other hand, we've got Lebanon on the other side. We've got Tinker played by Babar. I think he usually plays the Tinker, so no big surprise. Snoop always got his hands on that Tidehunter. Massive playing a carry. No big surprise either. He's going to have his hands on that Morphling. We've got ET on Lion, and then finally Toto on Crystal Maiden. And this is pretty much the standard role distribution for the Lebanese boys, so no big surprise here. As we're still waiting for the game to get started now. Serbia's ready. Lebanon, are you ready? Lebanon is ready, so it's going to go down. And Babar dropping his usual very long shout-out list. Shout-out to Kaki, Paki, Pikachu, Kikoni, Align, Sin, Couch the Noob, Abed, Pierre the Idiot, and Mugarbil. nice way to pretend you have a lot of friends. And we'll see how the laning phase turns out, because I'm a little bit interested in seeing especially how the Sentinel decides to put their lanes. Actually both sides. Looks like they're opting for some dual lanes right now, actually. Lich and Windrunner up top, and Vengeful Spirit together with Shadow Fiend mid. Could just be a little bit of mobility to get the vision going while Clockwork is supposed to solo bottom. On the other hand, we've got Lebanon, Crystal Maiden, Tide, as well as Morphling sniffing around mid. Might be a tri-lane they're going to put top, and Tinker definitely going to be their solo mid. Lion offlane could be a good decision if he gets to solo against the Clockwork. Should be a fairly easy lane for Lion. Clockwork can't really get in on him with that battery assault. The moment he moves forward, he's going to get impaled, and Lion will be all fine. So perhaps we're going to see a lot of the early game from Serbia depending on the skill of this Vengeful Spirit and the successfulness of her gangs. Getting some good gangs out for that Clockwork bottom is what can kill the Lion. It's what can kill mid for that Shadow Fiend and secure his farm. And, yep, time is up. The creeps have spawned and the rune is up top. It's a haste rune that Serbia have got their eyes on right now, and they could definitely use this for something. Do not choose to give it to the Vengeful Spirit, however, to the Windrunner. So that does seem like they don't want to try to First Blood the middle, but just keep this safe. And taking the haste on the Windrunner, perhaps to put a little bit of extra harassment on this Morphling, who actually seems to be soloing top for the moment, while Tide and Crystal Maiden are a little bit away from him, but they are making their way up there just now. Windrunner trying to get a farm on, so is Morphling, of course. We're in the start of the laning phase, and we might see something cooking up already once these Lebanese guys meet this Vengeful Spirit out here. Will we have an engage, or will we just have a little bit of respect? Vengeful Spirit placing a ward, that's all that's going to happen for now. But definitely this top lane is going to be the place for all of the action. Crystal Maiden, Tide, as well as Morphling. A lot of powerful slow and the waveform. Morphling is going to get some hits in once he waveforms in because they're going to be so slow from the Gush and the Crystal Nova. And we know when Crystal Maiden gets level 2, so she has both spells. She's got the ability to lock them in place as well as slow them. And that's going to mean a hell of a lot for this Morphling, not only for his ability to kill, but for his ability to farm. A lot of good harassment can come out of these Scourge heroes. And we'll see how it plays out. Tinker's already level 3 in mid, putting a good deal of pressure on this Shadow Fiend, as he should. Could play a little bit more aggressively with that level 2 laser that he's picked up. Might go in and throw a little bit of a laser on him to try and rip him off his HP regs. Does have quite a bit of them, though, does this cat Shadow Fiend. Up top, still nothing going on. Vengeful Spirit trying to get a little bit of a pull, it seems. Or stealing the pull from the Scourge, but that's not going to happen. They've already got their pull. Down on bottom, we've got Clockwork against Lion, of course. Not going to pay too much attention to this lane, as it should handle itself. But as it looks right now on the gold amounts, Lion is a slight bit ahead on this one by a couple of creeps. Up top, Morphling trying to get some damage out on Lich, as they're Lich as well as Windrunner are dealing massive loads of damage to their Crystal Maiden. And this might actually be the issue for the Lebanese guys up here. They're playing Morphling, who's short range, Tide, who is melee range, and Crystal Maiden long range against double long range and a short range. And now Tide might have found himself going way too far in. He's going to get stunned completely out of position and get bursted. Venged on Shackleshot as well as Nova was going to bring him down immediately. And Snoop was not expecting that, but he definitely should have expected it. I think he even had Vision of the Heroes all the time, so a little bit of a mistake coming out there. Morphling Crystal Maiden putting some pressure on Gordon's Windrunner. Not as much as they would probably like to, though. Tinker in mid, putting pressure on Cat's Shadow Fiend as well. Should be winning that middle lane as the Tinker. This is a very, very brilliant lane for him if he gets the good start off. Especially if he gets a kill on that Shadow Fiend, so he gets a level or two in advantage, this Shadow Fiend is going to be locked down completely until he gets a gank. You're going to see the moment he moves up to try and get a creep, the Tinker just forces him away. And Shadow Fiend knows he can't take this fight, so Tinker doing the right thing here. Might even choose to play it even more aggressively, and we'll see if he chooses to do that. So, buying Clockwork down on bottom. Looks like the balance has shown. Grazine is ripped from regs, and Lion has a flask, and has chosen to go for boots first, so really trying to put some aggressive play up down here on bottom, putting pressure on that Clockwork. Clockwork does have the gold for a bottle. We'll see if that's what he chooses to fly out or not. Shadow Fiend has picked up a haste. This could be his get-out-of-jail-free card against the Tinker in mid, if he gets caught off guard. Still up top, looking for a little bit of more action, especially the Scourge side. Once they get their level 3s, the level 2 Gush, the level 2 Waveform, and both of Crystal Maiden's spells are going to do a lot of damage, and they could potentially just burst out this Vengeful Spirit with 550 HP. Or the Windrunner, it might be an engage here. We've got the Gush, we've got the Frostbite, Morphling is waiting. There it's going to come, the Waveform gets Gogi. Gordon, of course, is Gogi. And Lebanon got the response kill on this lane that they needed ever so much, and it's going to give them important levels. Tides up to level 3, Maiden level 3, giving them that Crystal Aura. Well, Brilliance Aura, rather. And they might even choose to dive this. Very aggressive play coming out of Lebanon. Gush is on. Waveform is going to miss Victor, and he's going to retreat to safety, and now Crystal Maiden is locked in place. This does not look good at all for the Lebanese guys. Gogi has already finished off Toto, and they're trying to go for more. Tidehunter, Morphling, they're both out of position now, need to retreat. Tajdanu is moving a little bit back and forth. There's the shackle shot, beautifully executed by the Serbians, and Snoop is in trouble. Is there another Nova from Lich? No, Lich is out of mana. Vengeful Spirit does have a stun, and it's gonna reach. That's gonna be enough. Gordon takes Snoop. Meanwhile, Cat actually manages to kill that Tinker and middle his Shadow Fiend on the back of that Haste Rune. So Serbia looking strong, 4-1 already at 5 minutes, and they've really shown where this game is going to be played, how it's going to be played, aggressively on top and mid lane, quick response to the engage from Lebanon on top that turned out not as they would have hoped. And so far Lebanon can really be satisfied with bottom lane, but that's all for now that is going their way. And could really expect this line to TP up top pretty soon and assist the Scourge, of course Lebanon, in their fights up top. Having that line up there together with the Tide Morph and Crystal Maiden is definitely one, if not two, safe kills on these low HP heroes. Finger of Death almost single-handedly kills that Lich together with an Impale. And we'll see if he decides to do that. So far he's staying down on bottom. Clockwork is farming up whatever he can. He's picked up Boots, didn't get the bottle, he got Boots and a Flask. He's up to full HP, and he needs to be on full HP against this Lion, might I add. If he's not on full HP all the time, this Lion is just going to see the opening and go straight in, Impale Finger, and that's all he's going to have said. He's going to find a rune now, though. What's he going to do with it? Demon Witch sitting on an Invis rune, making his way into mid. If Cat doesn't know this, he could be in trouble. He's got wards on the left side, but not in the right side, and this is going to be trouble. Lion could get in for the engage now. Tinker's moving forward. There's the Impale, Finger, and Rocket instantaneously takes out Cat's Shadow Fiend. Very important kill coming out for Lebanon here, settling the score in mid to 1-1. And now, looking at the levels, we've got Shadow Fiend and Tinker, both level 7, but on that level scale, I would still say Tinker is the stronger one-on-one hero. Of course, the Shadow Razors from Shadow Fiend, very powerful, but will not be able to take the fight to this Tinker unless he gets a very good rune for it. While we were looking there at mid, we've actually almost lost a Sentinel Tower up top. I'm not sure how that happened, but Lebanon have been pushing through up here, and they are almost one tower ahead of the Serbians now. There's a save call. We will throw in a save here with a very creative save name. There we go. Alright, the pause is over, we're gonna go. Oh wow, didn't I resume it? Oh, I did. Fucking hell. a little bit of a mess up there on the pause resume. Hope they don't mind too much. We've got Windrunner, is she up to level 5? Yes she is, that's gonna be very important for the Sentinel up here. The Serbians, having this level 5 Windrunner with that level 3 Power Shard is gonna deal massive amounts of damage inside the Vengeful Spirit stun. Put a Frost Nova on top of that and you've got a secure kill on this Crystal Maiden. Perhaps even on the Morphling, as he's taking a lot of harassment damage. We just see the power of this, as Cat does get a kill on the Tinker in mid with the aid of Clockwork, who left bottom lane to get this important kill through for the Serbians. And when the score was settled for Lebanon in mid, Serbia chooses to go in and help out the Shadow Fiend Cat, and this is something he's going to be very happy about. Not only does he get a kill, he gets a second rune now as well. He's going to get 8-minute rune. If it's bottom, if it's top, Clockwork's going to get it. They both have bottles. That looks very good for them. Clock's going to get it, a DD. And he's making his way up top. Question is if Tide had vision on him there. If he didn't, the Scourge up top might feel safe, but they're far from safe right now as they're standing in a 2-against-4 position. Clockwork did use Hookshot in middle, so that's not available. Morphling is going to waveform away. He's going to meet a friend he doesn't want to be friends with. Clockwork's going to fire off that rocket, and Morphling is cornered. He does have another waveform ready, and this could actually be trouble for Gordon. If Morphling sees this option, he can waveform over. He is going to do so. One hit. Second hit takes down Gordon, and Massive is caught by his own Necromancer. Can't get out. And that's going to give that kill to the Clockwork. Meanwhile, Babar got the kill in mid with the aid of Snoop's Tidehunter. And that settled the score a little bit while Lion has shown up here. Oh, I completely missed that while looking at who was actually getting killed. Lion finished Vengeful Spirit as well as Lich. And it looks like he's not even done yet. He's turning around for the Clockwork. There's the Tide Gush. Does he have an Impale? He does. There it is. One hit, two hit. It's gonna hit it. It's gonna be enough. Lebanon nailing this team fight, getting it 5-3. So getting a full team wipe. on the back of this fight, I believe the score was 4-2 beforehand, so yes, my math skills do indeed work. Or actually, it was 5-2, so they won it 5-2 this exchange. Clockwork already had the kill in mid beforehand, so I guess you can't count that as part of the team fight. So a brilliant team fight coming out for Lebanon. Gonna have a quick look at the creep stats on the back of that team fight. We've got 35 on the Windrunner and 35 on the Shadow Fiend, so those guys are tied. Then we've got 31 on Tinker, and surprisingly enough, 43 on Lion. Lion has a very huge farm here. As Tide is going in, Gosh, he does have the level 6 for the Ravage. Not gonna use it just yet, but he's gonna be content to just use the Gosh and back off a little bit. Crystal Maiden firing off a Nova and gets a quick Terror in response. Nobody dares to make the engaging move, but now Clockwork does it. He's caught Crystal Maiden out completely, and that's the power of the hookshot we talked about in the beginning of this game. Catching out these guys in the team fights, in the gangs, setting it up perfectly for Serbia, and there was no way Lebanon could respond to that one apart from going on another lane. That's what they're going to do. Lebanon, Babar, as well as ET, finishing off that Shadow Fiend down on bottom. He's definitely not getting the space that a Shadow Fiend would want right now. He's up to 3 deaths, and Lion is doing a brilliant job here by being a lot of places on the map. He's even picked up a Smoke of Deceit now to prepare for his next gang, and he's only 900 short of that early Blink Dagger he can get together with his treads. So ET having a magnificent game right now. Up top, Vengeful Spirit, one creep away from level 6, he's gonna get it there, could go for the swap. Probably not interested in swapping a Tidehunter though, as that's gonna give him a very good ultimate. But if somebody else shows up, this Crystal Maiden is showing up, could be an opening. Rocket is gonna give them vision, as well as this ward from Baya up there, so they know exactly what's going on. Clockwork makes his way back. When is Hookshot ready? It should be ready now, it's ready in 1 second. And they might even go for this engagement. Lion does have mana to TP and use both of his spells almost, so they need to be careful of that. Lebanon, however, are going to use a smoke. They're going to get completely spotted by this Lich, but Lich does not see this coming because of that smoke. The ward does not give the smoke away, but now Clockwork catching one in his cog. He's actually catching two in his cog, and Crystal Maiden is going to take the fall probably after this. Oh, is he? No, Lebanon are turning around. Lion, Morphling, both in the mix. Power Shot's going to almost bring down Morphling, but he's going to be just fine for now. And Serbia got picked off, 2 heroes for 1 there. And Lebanon will be happy to get a little bit of farm up here. Some late treads coming out on this Morphling. He has not had a good farm this game at all. He's got 18 CS, and he's going to replicate back to base, get up those treads, and see how much he can do to recover his farm. Shadow Fiend, on the other hand, has been nerfed as well, but he's getting the farm done. He's up to 56 CS now on that bottom lane, got a lot of free time from that fight up top. And not only did he get farm, he's also pushing the tower here. Very important for the Serbians to get into the tower game here as well. Trying to get down the first tier 1. And Shadow Fiend, we just know his power for pushing towers. Immediately takes out this creep wave, gotta put pressure, and if Lebanon doesn't respond within the next 20 seconds, they're gonna lose this bottom tower to Shadow Fiend and his army of creeps. Tide is gonna be the first guy moving in to respond. Lion has used the smoke. Shadow Fiend is in deep trouble. He's definitely gonna pay for his greed to get that tower now, and that's all it's gonna be. Lion takes that kill. 100 gold away from the blink. Shadow Fiend did get the tower in trade though, so he could probably be happy with this, getting a full tier 1 and a lot of farm down on bottom. Smoke has been used, Vengeful Lich looking for some prey. They've got lots of mana on both heroes, so could kill anyone they manage to find. They've got Clockwork up here with them as well. Tinker is in a bad position in mid if this smoke gets to be used properly. Vengeful, Illusion is going to be found by the Lebanese guy, so that's not going to be too much coming out of that. Vengeful Spirit stun, is there going to be a Nova? There's going to be a Lich ulti, it's not going to bounce though as Tinker makes it out of there. Tidehunter, Gush, Rocket, now Lich is suddenly the one in trouble, and Clockwork dove in for it and didn't get anyone, and now he's going to die to Tinker. Tinker very low, no HP whatsoever, but neither does this Lich have, so he has to retreat. And we've got Shadow Fiend TPing in mid, together with Venge. He's going to take the kill with one raise on Babar, who is too far ahead. And meanwhile, Gordon took a tower up top, so another good exchange coming out for the Serbians here. Certainly getting the tower pushing going. And the Lebanese guys need to find a response for this. That response is going to be Lion. Just look at that Shadow Fiend dying instantly. And he's not done yet. The Frostbite is going to come off. And Tidehunter, Gush, is going to seal the deal. ET has a mega kill, and he might even... gone for that Lich perhaps if he didn't have the mana for it, else he definitely would have. So Lion is really paying out for the Lebanese guys right now, and we got the action game we called for. We've got 24 kills in 14 minutes, so there you go, almost two kills per minute. And the pushing is going on as well. Two towers down for the Scourge side. Almost one down for the Sentinel. I believe perhaps almost two, actually, as Morphling is trying to push bottom a little bit. And Lich is going to get spotted by Lion. He does have mana. Impale is there. Hex is going to be there as well. No, it's not. He's going to blink out wisely as he sees Windrunner approaching and doesn't get shackled to the tree. Would have definitely killed him with all the other Sentinel heroes who have arrived. And good escape by Lion, and important because it gives them the farm on the sides that Serbia went so far in for that kill. So many heroes arrived, and that's going to give Tinker free farm. It's going to give Morphling farm until that Shadow Fiend arrived. And they're still going to be able to hold middle. Or are they? We're going to see the tower is actually taking drastic amounts of damage. And Lebanon are not even in position. What was that impale? He was trying to blink, but it didn't work. And now he's in trouble. Clockwork is in on him. The stun is there. The Nova is there. And ET looked like he was lagging because that impale made absolutely no sense whatsoever. He's going to be taken out by Grisine's Clockwork. He's going to be happy to get all that gold from the Mega Kill streak. And he desperately needs it as well after being raped so hard on that bottom lane. Looking over the creep stats, he's got 37 and Lion's got 58. And had complete control of the lane. Lich on a gang train with three of his friends. Who are they going to go for? It's going to be the Morphling. Morphling senses that something is coming up and has retreated. They might, however, be looking to get into middle. The smoke is still running. Of course, Clockwork can sell and buy items in the smoke. It doesn't reveal him, so he's still smoked even after buying that Vitality Booster. Crystal Maiden might find herself out of position in a short while if Clockwork sees the opening. But he doesn't. Lebanon are approaching now. The Clockwork Rocket is going to spot who's TPing. They've got Lion, Crystal Maiden, as well as Morphling. The smoke has been used, but Serbia will know that smoke was used because of that rocket, so not too good smoke usage. Seems like they're just waiting for them, however. Just want them to go into the woods and get spotted. And now Lebanon might have actually got the better of them. They've surprised them. Tidehunter is at the back. He's going to use Gush. This is going to be a perfect Ravage. Lich is already dead from the finger from Lion. Lion's Hex is going to come out on Shadow Fiend. Swap is going to save Shadow Fiend for now. He's going to get a good ultimate off on Morphling, though. Massive amounts of damage. Does finish him off as Vengeful takes the fall. Tinker takes the fall. Lion trying to get whatever he has got out, but he's going to get killed as well. So the decision to wait for Serbia did actually turn out for the better, as Crystal Maiden always going to get Shadow Fiend, but then get killed. Full team wide coming out of Sentinel, and an ultra kill for Gordon, who almost is going to be able to pick up an 18-minute Hex on the back of this, only 1k gold short. And, that was not what Lebanese guys were looking for when they engaged this. And it even looked, it looked like a pretty good engage when that Tidehunter got in, but it turned out horrible as the Shadow Fiend was able to get a perfect ulti off on the Morphling and not get bursted out. And the Lebanese guys must be sitting there thinking, how do we structure the next teamfight? And what they should be going for is definitely bursting out this Shadow Fiend to avoid those raises and that Requiem of Souls.
Player's forces are under attack.
A lot of smoking going on in this game. It's good to see that both teams have really adapted to the version, getting a lot of Smoke of Deceits out and trying to use them for whatever ganks they can make with them. As the Sentinel top tower might finally take the fall, it's been low for about almost 10 minutes, I think, or at least 5 to 10 minutes, and now it's finally going to take its fall. It's going to get denied by the Lich here, so Bayer is happy to deny that one. Tinker's got his BOTs. Important to note as well, this could be very crucial to Lebanon if they can utilize these boots of travel to get those gangs going. They've got a nice setup for that with Lion together with Tinker, especially Lion with a blink. Blinks in, hexes the target while Tinker TPs, and then comes the party burst, you might say. It's going to deal ridiculous amount of damage with laser, rocket, impale, and finger. Hoping to see Lebanon pulling off that combo a couple of times against heroes who are astray, like this Clockwork, completely on his own. And Lebanon might even know it if one of these wards is theirs, but it's not. It's all of them are Serbian. Lebanon have got defensive wards up here, got a defensive ward down here, and also defensive ward up here. So certainly guarding the bottom lane. Well, Clockwork got an engage. I didn't even see. He's low. Lion trying to get the hits. It is going to be enough. So an exchange there. Clockwork for the Tinker. Clockwork actually killed Tinker on his own. So sending a little bit of a signal there to the Scourge side that he's actually able to do it. And that of course means that the Scourge need to be careful not to let that Tinker walk too much on his own. Will not see the Clockwork coming, of course, with that long range hookshot. Wards do not cover against hookshot. And Tinker will need to be careful if that's how it's gonna go. Shadow Fiend, using his ulti, he cancelled it, didn't really want to go for it anyway. But look at this Morphling, he's just so crippled. He's got treads and a ring at 20 minutes. A very, very insignificant farm compared to the other heroes. He's gonna get his Perseverance now. And does not look good for him. Let's have a look at Gordon. He's got the Ginzu, that was what I was looking for. 19 minute Ginzu and face boots, very, very remarkable. On the back of that ultra kill he got not too long ago, as well as the two towers, actually the three towers that the Serbians have taken down now. Shadow Fiend, is he getting close to the BKB? What's on the Crow? A player's forces are under attack. Have a look. There's nothing on the Crow. He's got the Mithril Hammer in base, meaning that he needs about 700 gold for that BKB. And once he gets that up, he can do a nice lot of comboing together with Clockwork, of course, catching people. Is going to enable Shadow Fiend to get a pretty good ultimate off once they're stuck in the cog. There's the swap to combo it with as well. And yeah, just a lot of good stuff can come out with that combo from the Sentinel side once that BKB is up. So the Scourge need to be ever more careful against the Shadow Fiend once that BKB comes up. And of course the Lion Hex is their primary weapon against that BKB. Hexing and bursting out the Shadow Fiend with all the stuff they've got could definitely be an approach to the teamfight. But of course this guy is proving to be a threat as well. Gordon, with that huge farm, they cannot really choose to ignore him either. And it's going to be hard for Lebanon, but they're going to try to get the best of it. Dust is off. Shadow Fiend's going to get found. He's completely done for. This is what they wanted. Gets bursted out, and they're not done yet. Tidehunter gets a nice ravage on three heroes. This could be huge for Lebanon. He does get killed afterwards though, but this is going to be in the death of Clockwork without a doubt. Frostbite as well as Impale is going to finish him off. Morphling is chasing in, he's getting dangerously low, probably got hexed by the Windrunner, does get stunned, he didn't have the time to replicate, or he didn't have the mana, but now Tinker is going to get response on the Vengeful Spirit, 3 for 2 so far in the favor of the Scourge. Frostbite comes off, are they going to go for more? Just needs a blink and a hit from the Lion to kill this Lich, but he's not aware, he's running the long way around and it's not going to cut it, and Lich will probably safely escape from this as he does have a TP, yes he will indeed. However, Windrunner could be in trouble. Lion finds her. In comes the hit. Impale. Windrunner has been popped, but Tinker is going to be able to finish her off. Oh, he doesn't have any mana. They can't kill her. A little bit of a miscommunication coming out from Lebanon there, and they need to be very careful not to miscommunicate against the type of play Serbia are coming off with now, as mistakes will be punished. But a good fight for Lebanon, nevertheless. And important to kill the Shadow Fiend before he gets the BKB up. Now he doesn't have it yet. He's 500 gold away from it as Tinker TPs into middle to try and pressure him ever so much as he can. Firing off a rocket, rearming, probably going to use another rocket, just trying to put that pressure and push the tower while he's at it. Windrunner farming down on bottom. Indeed, it's going to be a little bit of a rocket spam coming out from this Tinker. Third rocket there is going to TP home and regain mana. Chosen to go for a Soul Ring as well, interestingly enough, on that Tinker, meaning that he definitely settles for an harassment build in which he TPs in, uses mana, rearms, uses mana, rearms, uses mana, and eventually TPs out. So a very harassment-heavy build, as Soul Ring, of course, does get reset by the rearm spell from that Tinker. You can really use this to do a lot of powerful harassment with those rockets. And it might be what they need to give the Morphling his space. Holding the other heroes in place, keeping them low on HP in the other lanes is going to disable that. As Lion almost gets killed in mid while we're having a short look at Morphling up top, so is Clockwork. And now Tidehunter is the victim. Oh, Windrunner is too far in though. She could be in trouble. Swap's going to save her. But what about the Vengeful Spirit? Tidehunter is spotted by the Clockwork as well with that rocket. And Lich and Shadow Fiend are trying to get the job done, but nobody actually falls in this engage. Even though both teams really want to get the job done, nobody's able to. And they're all going to retreat without sacking a single kill, as the Shadow Fiend does indeed have this BKB up now. What about the Morphling? Did he gain some usage in that idle time? Yes, he definitely got better. He's got 85 CS all of a sudden. Third on the CS board, suddenly, after that little bit of idle time he got. But still the top two CS are on the Sentinel side. Windrunner as well as Shadow Fiend are over the 100 mark, while three Lebanese heroes are about 80 in average. One of them being this Tinker farming up mid. Windrunner is going to take this regen rune up top, probably, yes she is. And she's got herself a ring of health here. She did have a ring of regen before, and it might be in the base. No, it's not. So she actually sold the ring of regen to buy a ring of health. And that definitely looks like she's not going to use that one for a hood, because then she would have kept the ring of regen as well. So it's probably going to be a Lincoln Sphere, perhaps. A brilliant counter to the Lion as well. It's going to eat one of his spells. But then again, if Lion is smart, he can counter it as well himself. Drain mana instantly breaks Lincoln without even having to channel it. So if he wants to go for that Windrunner, can blink in, mana drain, hex, and she's going to be hexed instantly before she can even react with her own hex. And we'll see if Lion is able to pull that off. Tinker is getting his farm on. What item is it going to be coming out on Babar next? We're going to see what that is. But a little bit idle right now. We had a lot of action during the first 15 minutes, but now it's stalling a little bit as the teams are trying to get their farm on. It does look like Serbia want to make the engage. And oh, this Lion. Oh, it's actually a Morphling Replicate, so never mind that. Found the Windrunner out here, and he's going to know that she ran away. So this could be an opening for Lebanon. But so far, they're settling to have a Tinker pushing up top. And once he moves away from there, it's probably going to be because somebody shows up to defend. And then they can take a 5-on-4 down on bottom. Vengeful Spirit is going to stun that Replicate of Lion, trying to bring it down. Not really sure why she's doing that, using so much energy on that. But Sentinel, Serbia are not responding to this push up top. They're actually going to let Tinker take quite a munch on this tier 2, if not the full one. They're going to try to get a trade for it. They're using the smoke down on bottom, but Lebanon is standing defensively, wisely standing on defense here, while Tinker pushes that top tower. He's already taken half. So has Serbia taken half of the bottom. So we'll see who actually gains most in this exchange. Shadow Fiend is pushing through. Wants to get the tier 2 now. He has the entire team on backup. His Clockwork is jumping in on the Tide, catching him outside the fight. There's the BKB from Shadow Fiend. There's not going to be a Tide ulti coming out here. Completely wasted that Requiem, though. I could have just done a hit on the Tidehunter, but it's probably going to be happy to sack that tier 2 as well as the Tidehunter. And Serbia are going to retreat and try to defend bottom, mid as well as top. Morphling is farming mid. He's going to have the Lincoln Sphere up now, so did recover quite nicely. Has indeed the exact gold needed for that Lincoln Sphere. He's going to get it right there. But no, Serbia are not defending mid and top. They're actually going to leave it to get a Roshan, and Lebanon have no idea what's going on, so this is a very good call from Serbia to get that one. And Serbia are in a very good position for this right now. They've taken down four towers and have a Roshan. A Roshan? Yeah, there you go. They've got Roshan kill as well, so they've got the Aegis on the Shadow Fiend. And if he chooses to go for a Blink Dagger now, he can really get into that fight. I'm going to call for a save, so I'm going to do that right now. Oh, it's going to be Lebanon saving, actually. Very mannered of Lebanon to pull out that save. But yes, if he does indeed get that Blink Dagger, he can set up so nicely with the Clockwork, of course. Clockwork using Hookshot and the Cog, and then Shadowfiend just blinks into it and pops BKB and uses that Requiem, and that's definitely going to take out one, if not two, heroes caught in that Cog, as neither of the Scourge heroes actually has enough HP to survive a Shadowfiend ultimate, I believe. Offling is farming, pushing top. Tinker's farming, pushing bottom. Lebanon are probably going to sack this tier 1 down on bottom. Finally, getting this bottom tower at 28 minutes. Should really go for getting some towers now to gain that map control and awareness further out on the map. But it's going to be Avenged TP. Quick TP with a shift stun. Doesn't have any backup coming for him though, so now he might be the one in trouble. Was hoping for secondary TP from his team, but never got it. Nice swap though, might get him to safety, and yes indeed it will. Tinker doesn't dare pursuing him, and wisely enough he doesn't do it. Rocket from Clockwork. Wow, he cancelled the TP. Nothing is going to come out of it for the Sentinel. Lion is engaging on Windrunner, however. Blink, Hex, Impale. Clockwork Hook is going to miss. That means a kill for the Lebanese guys, probably waited with the title too wisely to catch the clockwork as well. But this Windrunner is actually very tanky, and Lion can't finish the job, and now they might be in trouble themselves. Our Tinker's going to go there to finish the job, so that's brilliant. That rocket was enough. Shadowfiend going to get two raises off. Lich last hits. Clockwork was way too far in. Lich ulti. Lich ulti, does it get a couple of lucky bounces on the Tinker? No, it doesn't. Yes, it does. It gets one more. Shadowfiend has the blink up. He's going to follow him. One raise. Going to miss. Can he hit the second? Yes, he can. He's going to get the kill. Tidehunter falls as well to that Lich. So, Serbia definitely got the best of that fight. As Morphling, wow, just as I'm scratching my forehead, Morphling actually replicates in and takes out that Lich. And turned out to be, looks like it was a 3-for-3, but I believe Crystal Maiden died as well, so a 4-for-3 for the Sentinel side. And didn't use the Aegis for it either. Important. As they might be able to take a tier 2 tower in mid now, perhaps knowing that that Tide ultimate is down. And Shadowfiend ulti is ready. Also, Lion ultimate is down for another half minute. And Shadowfiend seems to be pretty confident in pushing off this mid. Should still have his BKB ready, I believe. So, yes, indeed he does. It's a BKB 9. Morphling is going to go in, pressuring him away. Doesn't even pop his BKB. He knows he's safe as Lion is dead. No Blink Hex is going to come off. Looks like the supports on the Sentinel side are getting items as well. We've got a point booster coming out of Vengeful Spirit. Two brazes as well as treads on the Lich. Well, the Scourge has treads and one braze on the Crystal Maiden. And Tide has got boots and Planeswalker's Cloak. So better farm for the supports on the Sentinel side as well. And that's definitely not to be underestimated, the power of having fat supports. The fact that the Scourge heroes are going to use way more power on taking out this Vengeful Spirit now than 5 minutes ago is going to mean a hell of a lot to them. Because if she doesn't get focused out, you know there's going to be that swap going to help the carries. Perhaps get an additional stun in. Stay near for the Command Aura as well. Very important for Windrunner as well as Shadowfiend to get that extra damage on. And talking about extra damage, Windrunner's up to 300 plus damage with that DD on top of her. And if Tinker TPs for another wave, Gordon is ready. But he's actually going to show that he's there, so not going for the gang, just going for the farm. And farm he indeed does. Clockwork is called Lion. Sorry as I'm yawning. Nice swap from Venge. Is gonna save Clockwork. As Shadowfiend is jumping in. Gets the replicate from the Lion. And that's not gonna be good for them now though. Tinker rockets are flying in. The Scourge Heroes are in hot pursuit. Is the Tide ulti ready? Yes it is. And if they catch them now, that could be huge. Lion is gonna finish off that Vengeful Spirit with the help of Tinker. Clockwork revealing his position. Are they gonna use it for anything? No they're not. But they're still in trouble. They're caught out of position. Shadowfiend does not have a TP. This is huge for the Sentinel heroes if they manage to catch him before he gets out of here. But they're not aware. Or are they? Lion! Too late. He's not going to catch him. He's going to go in there and realize Shadowfiend is out of here as the TP animation is on the ground. And we'll TP up top to farm together with Morphling. Perhaps they're settling for a gang on the Windrunner. Is Finger ready? Finger is ready. Wow, why am I yawning so much? And a lot of mana is up on the line as well. That's going to go. Hex, Impale, Finger. When is it coming? This? No, it's not. He's going to get hexed. And Windrunner might even make it out of here. Another Shackle Shot is going to be blocked by Morphling's Lincoln Sphere. And Lion will have Blink Red in just a moment. Morphling is finding Windrunner's position. Lion is going to go over. Blink, Hex. That's going to be it. Impale, couple of hits. Important kill for Morphling. And with all the gold on the back of him, he's actually got 2,800 all of a sudden, and might be getting close to that Ethereal Blade, and Ethereal Blade together with Lion is just a killer, getting that Ethereal effect on the target so Lion can finger, they can burst out anybody on the Sentinel side instantly, and Tinker as well should not be underestimated in this game, he's getting a lot of gold, got the Mystic Staff and 2,200, he's going for a Hex, as we see him buying the Ultimate Orb. So he's almost got the Ginsu side of Vise, and 800 gold away from that. As Lich picks up an Invis rune, might be settling for a little bit of a gang. The wards down here are Serbian. So the Sentinel should probably... Ah, they've got a ward here, so they will know that... the Scourge does indeed know that Lich is Invis. Tidehunter is farming a little bit in the Scourge woods. trying to get up some farm on that hero is of course important as well. He does have 1500 HP and a Plains Walker's Cloak, so he's not easy to bring down. But if he doesn't get the ultimate off in the fight, get a good ultimate off, it's going to mean a hell of a lot to Lebanon that he gets that ultimate off. It's going to be what sets them up to get the good engage with the Tinker as well as the Morphling. And, well, without HP, he could very well be bursted out by what I talked about, the Clockwork Shadow Fiend combo could take him out before he gets a chance to use a good ultimate. And, yeah, they really depend on it. What's Shadow Fiend getting at? He's got an ultimate orb. He's going for the Yasha or a Skadi. Lion has got a BKB all of a sudden. I didn't even notice that, so that's very, very important for Lebanon as well. Getting that BKB up to keep him safe from the Lich Novas, from the Clockwork especially as well. And Vengeful, of course, can still swap him, and the Ginsu from the Windrunner is also going to be safe from that if he gets to BKB. Very important for him to get off those spells in the fight and get that utility from them. Lich has got Frost Armor level 1 only. That's interesting to see that he only skilled it once. But of course, it still gives the slowing effect, but who does it actually slow? It only slows the Tidehunter, so this 3 armor is not going to mean a hell of a lot. He could have had the 12 armor now, and then we could have talked about it, but the 3 armor is not a big deal. Replicate is made. It's stuck in the woods. Not what Morphling was hoping for. He's gonna lose that replicate. And now that that's down, we might actually see the Serbians finally going for it. Aegis on Nevermore still looking to use that to get this tier 2 in mid and force a team fight. And this is what it's going to come down. All the Sentinel heroes are here. Tinker just TP'd in. Morphling is out poking a little bit. He's got the Eagle Horn. Actually very, very close to that Ethereal Blade is Morphling now. But they're not going to be able to stop the Serbians from taking this tower safely. And it's just giving them more and more map control as Clockwork is engaging on the Tinker down on bottom. Did he use the hookshot, or is it still available? No, it's still available. Brilliant hookshot. Gets him in the cock. Vengeful Spirit is there as well. Gets the Howl off. There's the stun. Clockwork and Venge. Can they do it? Tinker is getting low. Clockwork is getting low. Does he have time to rearm? He gets swapped. He's going to turn in the opposite direction. And now he's going to get caught by the other Sentinel heroes. But he does finish the Clockwork, actually, with that rearm. So he's probably going to be happy to actually even get a kill there. And leaving Morphling a lot of free farm top as well in the meantime. A player's forces are under Serbians are smoked, looking for an opportunity. Could find this Tidehunter very well pretty soon now as they're moving up this slope. Tidehunter is sticking around a little bit at least, and he could be in trouble. Yes, he is. Stun engage. Shackle shot. Beautiful engage from Lion, though. It's going to catch all of them in an impale. All of them get caught in a ravage. And it's going to mean death for the Vengeful Spirit. But that's going to be the only kill, at least for starters, as now Morphling is going rampant on this Shadow Fiend. Wants to bring him down. Cancels. He does know that the Shadow Fiend has the Aegis. He's going to blow his load on Windrunner instead. He does have the Ethereal Blade. Is getting dangerously low on Windrunner. Morphling as well catches the full Chainfrost and completely misses the waveform. And that's going to keep Lich alive right now. Shadow Fiend has lost his Aegis and is going to get killed twice here actually by Lion as well as Tide. Just needs one Gusher, one Impale. That's going to do the trick, or just a couple of hits. Massive fight for Lebanon, and Serbia did not see this one coming. Beautiful Impale, beautiful Ravage. Set up that fight nicely. Got them 2 kills and 0 casualties. And actually even 3 kills as that Aegis was lost in the exchange as well. And that Morphling Ethereal Blade is just showing to be very, very powerful. And once he just morphs up some more agility, if he gets the next Aegis, you know how it's going to be. He morphs everything to agility. Forces every spell that he's got on top of one hero, bursts him out, and then it's a 5-on-4. Even if they bring down the Morphling after that, he does have the Aegis, and then they need to use their power to kill him. And he's back up, and everything is going to be ready again. Interesting item build on Windrunner. It's been a while since I've seen a Mask of Death on that hero, actually. So he's settling for a little bit of a carry Windrunner here with Lifesteal. Vengeful Spirit and Lich sniffing around the woods. Not going to find too much here, but Roshan is up. This is important. This is where it's going to be the next fight. unless if one of the teams manages to just pick it off without the other team noticing. Morphling's got an Ogre Axe as well. We'll see if he chooses to turn that into a BKB or a Saint Jinyasha. Looks like a good time to actually take a brief look at the CS scores. 190 on Windrunner, 200 on Shadow Fiend, against 180, 190, and 110. So actually the better farm this time around is on Lebanon in total. And just goes to show how much it has meant that they've got the last couple of team fights in their favor. Has enabled them to catch up on farm and even get past the Serbians. And they're really looking to pick something up now. Lebanon does not want to back down now that they've got the momentum. Lion Morph Tide, Crystal Maiden. Tinker is doing the pushing while the others are sniffing around. Playing it some sort of like a semi-bait. Want the opponent team to go on that Tinker, who now has his Ginzu up as well. Probably had that for a while, actually. He's got Ginzu and a lot of gold. And now Serbia finds themselves being the team that has to be defensive all of a sudden, as Lebanon are pushing this tier 2 in mid, looking all good for them right now. Morph with DD, DD ran out, it's not going to be available anymore. It's still going to get the tower. Shadow Fiend almost denies it, nice attempt coming out of Cat. And Lebanon are going to retreat. The question is what they're retreating to, if they're retreating to the base or if they're retreating to Roshan, because what we're looking at right now is a brilliant play coming out of Lebanon, setting up for Roshan. They're pushing bottom, they're pushing mid, and they have Vision up, I believe so. No, this one is Serbian. They don't actually have a ward up yet. Is there a ward on Crystal Maiden? No, there's not. So now the Serbians are actually going to see them going there. And question is if Morphling can choose to replicate into this line replicate and just instantly burst the Vengeful or the Lich with his combo. Doesn't look like he's going to for now at least, but if the team follows him, that could be huge. All staying at Roshan though, while Morphling goes in. They're faking it. They're faking it. The Serbians think that Lebanon might be there. The Howl is going to show that they're not, and so is the Clock Rocket. But there is a smoke on the Scourge Heroes. Lion is going to blink in and engage. What a brave engage on that Shadow Fiend, but they're going to try to burst him out. Swap's going to save him from Vengeful, but Vengeful is going to instantaneously die. So is Lion. And now the Chain Frost is bouncing between four Scourge Heroes. Beautiful Chain Frost coming out of Baya. And now Crystal Maiden is going to take the fall to a couple of Shadow Fiend hits. But Shadow Fiend is a victim as well to the Morphling. Tinker getting low, but he does have the HP to survive this Lich right now. And Clockwork is trying to catch them in place, but that's going to be his own death. Catching these guys off, doesn't want to take the fight with that Morphling. Triple kill Morphling, and he's not done yet. Fire! He's going to take the fall as well. Ultra kill for Massive, and now Lebanon are really looking like they're going to sack this one. If they get the Aegis as well on this Morphling, he's going to have Saint Jinyasha or a BKB almost. And he's going to have a lot of levels, Ethereal Blade up, and an Aegis is going to allow him to take these fights brilliantly. Morphed everything to agility to take Roshan very quickly, of course. As he should. Snoop doing whatever he can to tank it. He's not going to be able to. Might see him earning up himself to tank some more. He's going to leave Morphling with it, but Morphling is not going to be able to do it either. Yes, finally he earns himself. He's going to earn Morphling as well, probably. But they're not going to get it yet. Or are they? There's the earn. Morphling is getting earned, and yeah, they probably will be able to do it. Oh, gets bashed. Epic battle between Roshan and Tide and Morphling, but it looks like Tide and Morphling are going to come out victorious on the back of this urn. Taking turns of tanking. Nobody wants to tank it, and they're actually not getting it this time around either. Oh, if the Serbians only knew this. If they only knew this. But it is going to be successful for Lebanon, so we're going to see a save now. A DB, apparently. And let's see what that Morphling went for with all that gold. Tidehunter's actually almost got the gold for a Blink Dagger. We might see him picking that one up to give them that one up to get them a bigger and better team fight. Lion's got a PB as well. Wow, he's getting very, very fat on that Lion. Crystal Maiden got her hands on an Ogre Axe. Morphling is going for the Saint Jinyasha indeed. Yasha is finished, and he's got that Ogre Axe, and Tinker's finished the Shiver's Guard. So it's all going to be a matter of time before the Lebanese guys are going to overpower the Sentinel, it seems. Even though the Sentinel are picking up items as well, it just seems like every teamfight is going the Scourge's way on the back of this aggressively playing Lion as well as the powerful Morphling, who only looks like he's getting more powerful by the minute. Right, so a little bit of quiet. I'm quiet as the game is quiet. but of course we're going to have a look at what's going on right now. We've got all the Scourge heroes close to the middle lane. Looks like they want to try to force this, and this might not be the right approach for them right now. As the Sentinel side could easily stand defensively on the back of a good Frost, chain Frost. They could really get a fight going. Oh, the Sentinel going all in on a Replicate up here. And that is opening the midfield. The Scourge knows that they're all top, and now they could actually use this to push the base, as they are. Tinker's TP bottom. He's going to rape this creep wave very, very quickly on the back of two Shiver's guards, as well as the March of the Machines. Ginsu from Windrunner. Clockwork is going in. This is going to be huge for the Sentinel if they can take out the Tinker before the fight even starts. They can't. Line TP's in. Impales. There's going to be a big Tide Ultimate hitting all the heroes apart from SF, who did get his BKB off. Instant burst on the Windrunner with that shotgun Morphling, who does have the Aegis as well. Morphling finishing off the Shadow Fiend as well. Does not look good for Serbia. They've lost three. Two are left. Morphling is not done yet. He's going for further. Trying to get this Vengeful Spirit. He's not going to get him, though, as the Venge did have a stun up his sleeve. But this was what the Scourge needed to get this Rax. No way out of it for the Sentinel now, as the Morphling is even trying to overpower them now. Isn't going to catch them, though, as the Crystal Maiden is very, very low. She's going to TP out of here immediately. While the Scourge are trying to take the Rax, at least the base tower. They have to get at least the base tower. They've got 40 seconds, but the Morphling has so much strength morph that he doesn't deal much damage at the moment. He's still going to try, though. Ethereal Blades himself, apparently. I didn't even know that was possible. Well, that's interesting. And they are indeed going to get the Rax here. So, first Rax of the game, getting taken down by Lebanon, and completely well-deserved as well on the back of the teamfights they've pulled off. They are the correct, they are the right victor of this game at the moment, and is paying off by getting these racks. Venge swaps Lion, quick blink from Lion is going to save him. Waveform is going to wave away from the stun from Venge, but it's still going to hit. Didn't just cut it though. And with the racks falling and the Scourge retreating, we're going to have a save again. 27-36 is the score right now, and this Morphling just seems like a force that the Sentinel can't really deal with. It's what's winning the fight for the Scourge right now. He's got a 3600 gold again on the back of himself, so he's going to get that Sengen Yasha and almost an Eagle Horn pretty soon again for his Butterfly. And just, he is gradually going to overpower the Sentinel more and more in these fights, as they are not really getting any more items at the moment. Shadowfiend has been stuck with the same inventory for about 10 minutes. Windrunner, Crystalis has had that one for about 10 minutes as well, I believe, while Morphling is getting all the gold and winning the fights. There it is, the Sengen Yasha. He's got 2800 above. 2800 gold on top of that. And of course, with the strength he gains from that Sengen Yasha, he's not actually even going to be that low HP when all of his strength is morphed to agility. He's got a natural, not a natural, but a plus 65 strength. Actually makes him almost even as tanky, not as tanky as the Tinker, who does actually force Shadow Fiend to use his BKB, so that's very important. This could be an opening for the Lebanese team to push through. BKB down on Shadow Fiend for about another 50 seconds, and that's certainly an opening that they shouldn't miss out on. Tinker's got himself a Daygun as well. Wants to be a complete burst monster in this one with the Ginsu Daygun as well as Shiver's Guard. Serbia trying another desperate gang attempt on the back of these smokes, but they're not really going to find anybody. At least not yet, but now they might! No, he cancelled the TP on the Tinker. He's going to TP nowhere. He keeps cancelling TPs. Really mind-gaming the Serbians here, but now he chooses to TP in, and this is not what he wanted to TP into. Vengeful Spirit in a smoke, but his team isn't there! Clockwork is going to jump in now, though, and they are going to catch him. But is it going to be enough? No, it's not. Lion is out here. He's caught the Shadow Fiend. He's going to keep him in a stun lock while the Morphling is trying to finish off the team. But Tinker isn't getting any help. What's going on? Lebanon are going to get bursted out completely by the Serbians all of a sudden. And this was not what anybody saw coming. But now Aegis from Morphling is used. Shadow Fiend has 1 HP and he is going to escape with that Blink Dagger. And now Morphling finds himself all on his own against 4 Scourge Sentinel heroes. And he's going to get taken out, a full team wipe by the Sentinel. Who would have thought? And Serbia are still in the game. I cannot believe what I just watched. They just got a load of levels on the Vengeful Spirit and the Lich there. Looked like Lebanon was messing around a little bit in that fight. Morphling got completely wrong into it. Lion kept out the Shadow Fiend. Morphling didn't go for him. And then instead Tink actually got killed, so the Morphling was doing nothing. And they lost all the heroes one by one. Well, 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 and now the Windrunner is going to get very fed after that fight. He's got the gold for a Breeza, and even more. Lich got quite a bag of gold as well. He's got 1600. Vengeful Spirit has got a cloak on the back of his PB now and does have a lot of gold as well. Clockwork. We haven't actually looked a lot of Clockwork. A lot at him. He's got Aghanim's up, Vitality Booster, almost got the Blade Mail. It's going to be very useful against this Morphling in the fights if he does get that one up. It means that Morphling really can't take the fight with this Clockwork. At least it's going to be hard for him. Tinker's farming. We're actually going to have a save after that fight that Serbia just won. It's very important. Crystal Maiden has got her hands on 2 Ogre Axes. what an interesting item build that turns out to be. And now Windrunner didn't actually choose to go for the Breeza, but chose to go for the BKB. And that's going to be a 10-second BKB coming out on her at 51 minutes. That's going to mean a huge lot for them in the fights. Keeping Windrunner out of these stun locks, enabling her to use her Ginsu as well as Shackle Shot. So a nice choice of item, I have to say, coming out from Gordon. Tidehunter's got his hands on the pipe. Could make a very big difference as well. And now it's all going to come down to how well the next teamfight is executed. I have a feeling that if Lebanon win the next teamfight, the game is going to be theirs and it's going to be over. But on the other hand, if Serbia takes it, they could very well push it through and take at least Rax and be in a very good position to win it. Not sure why they were using that pipe then, actually. That seemed to make no sense. But they're all smoked, looking for a kill, baiting with the Tinker, nothing's going to come out just yet. The Serbians might see what is going on right now. However, they are making their move down there. Is this going to be the mistake of the game? They're all going in, Tide gets all an ulti on 3 heroes, Morphling on top of all of them. He's going to burst out nobody, he messed it up, but they're all going to get low. Tinker in there as well with all of his shit. Morphling does get taken out by Windrunner and Clockwork. But that's the only guy they're probably going to get in this fight, as now Clockwork falls as well. Shackle Shot beautifully placed on Tidehunter and Maiden, but that doesn't mean that she's going to escape with that Windrunner. Lion blinks, Impale, Hex, and now it's going to be Chain Hex coming out of this Tinker, and that's going to be all she said for the Sentinel side. Full team wipe, Serbia is done for, and this is probably going to be GG, as they've got a whole minute, almost, to take at least one side of Rax, if not the throne. We should definitely see them taking the middle. Could tank it with the Tide and just go for it with the TPing Tinker, but seems like the Moonwells are fairly interesting, apparently. Tinker's pushing out mid, getting the creep support. Should actually be in the base with them, and yes, he is going to change his mind and finally TP down here to help them pushing the base. It's going to be the base tower, and it's definitely going to be the Rax as well. There's 5 seconds on the first Sentinel hero, 10 on the next, and then we're up to 25 until the next one's going to respawn. So the Rax are going to fall. They might even take more than just these Rax if they want to. They could perhaps pressure the Serbians inside their own base and try to get this game over with. Could also go for Roshan. Roshan is going to have a cheese this time around. And it's going to be all Lebanons if they want. They've got full push on the Serbians. They cannot leave their base right now. However, they can swap the Lion. And he's going to BKB. But it's not going to be enough, though. The Lich ult is going to stop the teleport he was trying to pull off in that BKB. However, Vengestun, is it going to... Is there going to be a follow-through? Tinker's actually TP'd into the mix and finished off Lich. Now he's going to go for the Venge. This could be the game. Vengeful's going to fall as well on the back of that. So brilliant TP from Babar showing up at just the right time there. And now, the Sentinel, 3 heroes down again. GG, well played, is going to be the call from Victor. We're going to see if it's a thing that the team actually agrees on. So far, nobody's left. He's called the GG. It's not forfeit, he says. Nice shackle shot coming out on Tide and Tinker. Does Tide have his ultimate yet? No, it probably doesn't. It doesn't look like he's got it at least. And now Tinker's just pulling all of his shit on that Shadow Fiend. Chain Hexing, Dagon, lasers, and look at Cat just being ripped. Response kill from the Windrunner does take the Tide Hunter out, but now he's going to be in trouble. Seeing that this BKB is stopped, Tinker's going to go for him line as well. There's the Hex with the Impale, there it is. And he's going to take the fall as well. 4 heroes down for the Sentinel. And now it should be definitely it. There's the GG call coming out of Gordon. He leaves, and the first game, ladies and gentlemen, the first game goes to Lebanon. Stay tuned, we'll be right back with game number 2.